Welcome back to the Temple College Jazz Festival. Finally. All right. So, really glad to be back, and so glad that you're here with us live. You know, it's been so long. 2019 was the last one that we did. So, let's see. That was a tune entitled Now You Know by Joe Gallardo, based on a familiar set of chord changes. Anybody know?
All the things you are.
All the things you are. Very good. You win the prize. Okay. All right. You heard solos from Stephen Gocher on Tender Sax. Randy Zimmerman on trombone. Mi hermano, Norm Berger on the percussion. He's also my boss, but I'll get back to that later. Okay, and also a big thank you to Demetrius Allen and Nico Trujillo Castelblanco for playing the track. Alright, so before we play the next game, I want to mention that back in 1990, that's when this group was founded by Tom Fairley, who was my boss, let's see, Division of Fine Arts and both department chair at the same time. And he started this group, I think, back in 1990, and then also the Temple Symphony Orchestra back in, I think it was 92. So very influential in this town, and so in honor of him, and since we were supposed to celebrate 30 years, 2 years ago, we're going to do it, we're going to do it tonight. So please help me welcome Tom Fairley to the stage. Yeah.
Never pass up an opportunity to speak. First, I want to thank Ben for inviting me back. This was such a fabulous experience to be involved with this band for 26 years, and I really appreciate from the bottom of my heart that he's given me the opportunity to come up and just say something. I don't know if you heard Wycliffe's clinic this afternoon, but it was amazing. And Wycliffe, thank you for the wise words that you had for all the students and directors that were in the room. And I sat out there and listened to it, a lot of what he said, and I said, you're spot on. And you know, when I was applying for the job at Temple College, I was at McMurray University, and it was in the early part of 1990, and I was trying to think, I knew they didn't really have much of an instrumental program going at the time. That's what they hired me for. So I went into the interview with a list of things that I thought we should do, and at the top of the list was start a jazz festival. Now, I'd never ran a jazz festival before. I played in some big bands. I directed a college big band for years, but I thought, you know, that'd be a really cool thing to start. And we started in 90 with, I think, six bands from around the local area. And then in 91, we had eight bands, and Ron Wilkins, he's kind of a Texas legend, played. And in 92, Marvin Sam came in, and then Bill Watrous. And from there, it just blew up. As did the department. And if you're thinking about going to school somewhere, this is a fantastic place to be. Not only, yeah, give it up. You have university quality faculty, and actually they've achieved a partnership with Central Texas, with A&M Central Texas, and you can complete a four-year degree here. So that was one plug that I wanted to get, and I want to thank these guys. Some of these folks up here really helped me a lot at the beginning. Some of them are still in the band that I met my first year, like Frank Caldwell, Grant Matheson. And I would be remiss if I didn't mention the folks that are doing the work here at this school. The faculty here is amazing, and you know what? Two things I would say to you students, if you want to be in music. If you think you love music, that's enough, but it's got to drive you really wanting to work as hard as you can. And you never know where it'll take you. If you change your mind and do something else, you're going to learn things from working that hard to be that good of a musician that you can do virtually anything. But the folks up here, the other thing I was going to say is surround yourself with good people, whether it's your friends or the people that you work with. And I was very fortunate to be around when we hired three of the folks up here, amazing musicians. Ben Iron, absolutely world-class pianist. And I've overstayed my welcome, so let's do our tune.
Thank you.
Dave Wilde on the panel. Paul Mason, all the same. Laurel Dorado on the left. Thank you, Ben. Swinging. Tom started to mention a couple of the people in the band. I'm going to go ahead and introduce everybody now. Start with the trumpet section. How about that? Blake Waller. I'll just name them all from left to right of the trumpet section. So Blake, got Noah Alvarado. Bobby Gallegos. Sparky Thomason. Denise Doyle. From left to right, trombones. Brent Caldwell. Randy Zimmerman. Steve Saintsinger playing lead. David Lamer. And Brent Matheson. From left to right, saxophones. Greg Becerra. Marcus Duran. Colin Mason, Stephen Gocher, and Karen Batson. Rhythm section you just heard from Dave Wilde on piano. Dan Anderson on guitar. Dr. James Suter on bass. And Mr. Norm Bergeron. So we're going to do one more tune before we bring our guest artist out. This is a tune written by Dave Wilde, dedicated to the great Miles Davis. It's entitled Your Mileage May Vary. And it's going to feature Sparky on trumpet, Colin Mason alto, and Dan Anderson on guitar. Your mileage may vary.
next gentleman, I've been trying to get him to come to this festival for a long time now. It's been almost 10 years probably. And he's always been booked, you know, just can never get him. You know. So I finally figured out I got to get him like 2 years in advance to try and book this guy. So finally I did. So back in, 2020 was supposed to be when he was going to appear. And of course, you know, we know what happened. And then last year, you know, we thought we could try again. So he honored his commitment. He was going to be here. He saved the date. Fell through again. So thank goodness he stuck with us, and he's here this time. So please welcome to the stage Wycliffe Gordon.
Thank you. gentlemen on trombone. Colin Mason on the alto saxophone. So we're in that New Orleans state of mind. We're going to stay there. And I think that we may be closing this part of our program and come back and I'll play a little more in the second half. But this one is entitled The Eliza Jane. And if you know the words, you know, just sing along with us. Oh, the Eliza Jane. Anyway, we hope you enjoy. Y'all have a good time this weekend. Yes. I hope so. What I say, we play music, we make music for a living. And if you're doing that, it's a blessing. So if you find that you're in here playing music, making music, or listening to music, and that if you're not having a good time, it's probably your fault. Anyway, we're out of here.
We'll be back in a little bit, take a quick intermission, and then we'll hand out some awards, so stick around.
They're all my close friends. So thank the band. All right, without further ado, let's bring on Wycliffe Gordon.
So much congratulations, you know, to all of you that received awards and recognition, and I say just thanks to all of you from me for showing me, and I thank all the gentlemen and ladies up here, that this music has its place and is going to be around for a while, because you're the future generation of this music. So thank you guys, give yourselves a round of applause. So now we're going to start with a tune by Dizzy Gillespie. I'm going to feature myself and another trumpet. It's called Umbrella Man. And Dizzy was a serious musician, but he was really a kid at heart. And this tune kind of displays that. He's talking about an umbrella man who fixes umbrellas. And I'll kind of give you the story, but we hope you enjoy our rendition of Umbrella Man. Your parasol, it may be small, it may be big. Even has them all with what you call a thing of this. Pitter,
thank you. Then today, you meant to pass up. It made me strong, it made me big. Hate me passing on what you call a family. Live it, looks like rain. Live it, we don't mind the rain. He'll get your umbrella and then go on his way. Singing to tea, to Judy, I'm a Judy. To Judy, I'm a Judy. To Judy, I'm a A.
Section, so we hope that you enjoy Mood Indigo.
Thank you.
time to give my chops a little break. And I'm going to play one that's entitled, an original composition that's entitled Wishing Well. The original title was called Karen's Contemplation. I named it after one of my younger sisters. But this is an arrangement by John Mahoney, so we hope that you enjoy the Wishing Well.
Thank you.
piano solo. Our last number for tonight. And like I said, I hope you had a good time. I hope you had a wonderful time. And thank you. We're gonna pick up the pace a little bit. We're gonna bring Maestro out of my play on this one. And this is, someone asked a question in a master class earlier today. Paraphrase, but who's your biggest influence? Without hesitation, Louis Armstrong. As a musician, when I was young, because I loved the music that he played, but as a man, or as a humanitarian, as I got older and learned what Pops stood for. He used to open his shows with his All-Stars, with his theme song, when it's sleepy time down south, going back home in Indiana. He would always close the shows with this next one. We're gonna give you our rendition of Swing That Music. Thank you all so much. Swing That Music. Thank you. And no one wanna drum. Okay. Thank you all very much. You wanna hear one more? You know what? That's too bad, because we're not playing it. I'm just kidding. This next song is an original composition, features several members in the ensemble, and it's called We're Still Here. And it just speaks to our ability to just remain humane through everything that's going on. We're still here, and he's all right. So, if you feel like clapping your hands, stomping your feet, join us. Let's hear it once again for this wonderful, wonderful man. Thank you all so much. This is Rich still here. He's all right. I'm gonna talk, my talk. I'm gonna say my
So, if you want to meet Wycliffe, he'll be out in the lobby there, okay? So don't rush the stage, just meet him out in the lobby. All right, thanks guys, thanks for coming out. Enjoy.